Now we're just a whisker away from another exciting session of Countdown with Richard Whiteley and Ned Sherrin. Start the clock, please.
Yes, our champion is still here after beating off a very tough challenge. Will you welcome yet again Colin Pearce? So now meet your challenger, Pat Champion. Yes, well, of course, she's already a champion, of course. She's a seaside landlady from Blackpool. But you're in the winter. I thought most of other landladies go to Tenerife or somewhere, but she works as a bookkeeper at a teddy bear factory. But I gather that's no picnic anyway. But she's got four grown-up children, very keen on knitting, which is just as well, because would you believe that her third grandchild is due at the end of this year? So it's a granny champion. Well, welcome to you, and we wish you the very best of luck. Now, yesterday, among brilliant words which our guardian of the dictionaries came up with, there was one which was tonnages. Well, we are expecting him to weigh in with more words of wisdom today, leaving no stone unturned. So let's have more literary gems from Ned Sherrin.
After the drama of the last two, both Yvonne Warburton, who's the real guardian and judge and guardian of the concise Oxford Dictionary night, we thought we perhaps ought to start with something rather lighter. So I've been back to Professor Brainstorm's not entirely serious dictionary, which has quite new definitions of various words. You may not know that abominable is a piece of explosive swallowed by a male cow. An accident is a mark made by a chopper. Addition is what a dinner table has. And allocate is a greeting for Catherine. Got it? Allotment is a good deal intended, and I think that'll do to be going on with it.
That's not bad. Yes, you must give us more of those. That's very good. Okay, well, to the serious matters in hand, Pat Champion, our challenger from Blackpool, takes on Colin Pearce, our champion from Birchington in Kent. It's round.